Hi, this is Ricky San. I'm a Pi consultant. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Pi interface for RDBMS tips and tricks. Just in the past, I have experience with the Pi interface for RDBMS, so I just think it might be worth to share what I know. Talk about single tag query strategy, right? This is a very common way to configure your tag to collect data by RDBMS interface, right? And I said it is for testing purpose only. Why? It's because for all the tags you create, you are making a query to get the data from a database. And if you create too many of them, it will have performance issue because you are making a lot of load in your database because each tag are going to query your database. And if you have too many of them, then performance will have problem, right? You'll see skip scan, or you might see a problem like not scanning on time because the database just couldn't handle too much load. This is for testing purpose only, but it is the easiest way to configure a tag to collect data from a database. And then I want to talk about tag group query, right? This is very good for if you have multiple columns and you want to get their data from all these columns, then it is very good for that. But we also have the same problem, which is as you are creating more tags, you are querying your database simultaneously again. So this strategy will have some impact on your performance within the database. If you use too much, then it just have performance issue. That's why I wanted to mention about the tag distribution strategies, right? So what this is you have one tag that can query your database. And then once the data got queried into a table, right, from this tags, then it can distribute the data to other tags called target tags. And give you an example, right? In this table, you have timestamp, tag name, value, and status. And tag distributor strategy is very good when different tag name are on the same column. You see tag 1, tag 2, or tag 3. We could have create 3 different tags and 1 distributor tag. Then it would query once and then distribute the data into 3 different tags, if you know what I mean. So it's good for performance because you won't have to query your database many times. You just query it once and then you distribute the data to all these target tags, right? So some special configuration for distributed tags, that one distributed tags, you have to make a query in there, right? Also, location 3 is equal to -1. So that's the only tag that put a query there. You can put it in this extend descriptor, or you can put it in an SQL file. And then you have to create multiple target tags, right? In my previous case, I have tag 1, tag 2, tag 3. You have to name them the same, otherwise you won't get the data. Or you can put some alias into your target tag as well, so it link the data back into the distributor tags. And I think also you have to have location 4 to be the same for those distributor tag and target tag. So if your scan class is 2 for distributor tag, then you have to put your target tag to be scan class number 2 as well, right? Location, which is location 4. I make sure I have a column with all different tags, and then I distribute it to multiple tags, and it has been working great. Talking about if you have too long of a query, you may not be able to put it all into your extend descriptor. You might want to put it into SQL files, because if it is too long, there is a limited number of characters you can put in your tag attributes within extend descriptor. So use SQL files. It's not too complicated, but it is another thing. I mean, sometimes you just give up. I use extend descriptor because it works for me. I never get it to work from SQL files, right? Well, you will have hit a limit eventually. If you have a query that is too long, then you have to use SQL files. And lastly is, do you know we can store call store procedures, right? Within your even distributor tag, all these tags, RDBMS interface tag, you can call store procedures so that you can collect your data dynamically. Every month they have a table coming out, right? And then you might need call store procedures in order to get the data. And that's kind of like what I wanted to talk about. I think I don't want to touch in like the whole interface manual, but this is what I want to touch on. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. I'll see you next week. Bye.